definitely this time for a new stream, and it's been a while. So first of all, I want to warn you all, it's I'm not usually, I'm not really good at speaking in English. I'm a Spaniard. The last time I had to say any words in English was like 1 year ago. So it's going to be pretty cringe, and my pronunciation is going to be really bad, and deal with it, okay? So, well, why I'm not doing it in Spanish? This is a PvP video, and honestly, I don't know any PvP Spaniard other than a few friends. Most of my PvP friends are international, and they obviously will not understand a video in Spanish. And this is mostly a video dedicated for them, so... Well, what is this roulette festival I'm talking about? It's some sort of experiment I'm doing, you know, at this time of the year, most of the crystal boys are not even queuing. They are not fighting run. This option never pops, okay? So it's pretty boring, and I am forced to use casual match. So casual match is very boring because you can't actually see a progression, you can't see how your ranking goes up, down. What I did is work this. Let me show you. I'm going to open Discord. And that's friends chat, and this is going to be ERC. Okay, there. So, well, Roulette Festival. It is just basically to use many different jobs. All the jobs of the game, except 5 that I don't know how to use or I'm really bad or simply I hate. Like, for example, I don't like to play Samurai in Crystalline Conflict. I don't like to play Dark Knight in PvP. And there's not many I don't like to play, actually, but there's like 5 of them, and you will see them in this list. So how does it go? Well, whenever I lose, I change to another job, and I keep rotating. I simply rotate. For example, Gunbreaker is the 5th one to start. If it loses, it will be Warrior time. If it loses, it will be White Mage. So it goes on. As you can see, well, there's some data here already. You can see the total victories that the job got in casual matches. You can see the best win streak. You can see the total defeats, and you can see the honor defeat. Honor defeat, okay, this is funny to explain, but actually, I think that casual match are way more unfair than ranked, okay? In ranked, most of the players know how to play, and they are pretty decent. But in casual, you can have like 2 or 3 allies that don't know how to do anything. And you just can do nothing at all in those kind of others. It's just going to be a lose, and it doesn't matter how much you fight. Let me show you. Okay, these are honor defeats, captures of those honor defeats. You can see what damage, the kills, and you can see that my allies. Well, I tried, okay? I swear I tried, but not possible. There was many of these, and with many jobs. You try, but your team is obviously people. Of course, you can think, well, if there are times you had bad company, bad allies, you maybe can have bad enemies too. Well, it's not my case, at least, not with my land. So, I hope that if I'm streaming some strange and miracle of luck, but you know, I honestly no update, so it's going to be like that. What I'm going to do is, well, just going to keep doing it, and of course, honestly, it means that the job loses, so it's time for the next. For example, someone lost here, so it was time for the next in the list, that is wrong match. You can see it here. What happens? I already finished the end goal round. Basically, it means every one of the jobs already have 10 defeats. So we are going to start the game with the breaker, the warrior, and so on. Let's see how it goes. The good advantage is that Crystalline, we don't actually have to wait too much for the queue. It's one of the few advantages of Pathfinder. So, okay, it's gonna get done. Let's see how it goes. Well, okay, this video, this festival of my own, hopefully can be a really good way for you to know how to play PvP, because I'm going to be changing and using many different jobs, and you can see how I actually play it. For example, you saw the Gunbreaker, that really matches. It's true that you should be very well. Days and I might be a little sloppy. How's the meme? Sloppy? No. Okay, but the thing is, I might not be my most optimal, but you can probably see how I use some jobs fight. Oh, a huge elephant. Yes, that's very important. There we go. I'm an impact player, but for Gunbreaker I need to do this in the beginning. It's the easiest way to match. I want to have the target. There is a reason for why I'm using that, okay? I counter the enemies each time I have Nebula on. And I'm usually a grid aggro maker, so enemies are going to use it that way. I don't like to be with DPS stats, but it's one of the reasons. I need a tank. I need a tank precisely for this that I want to now. Anyway. Woo! Yeah. Okay, whenever I do those things, I say, Gunbreaker, do your thing. And that is Gunbreaker's thing, okay? Because he uses the limit break, people dies. It's pretty helpful. I love it. See, I'm being slightly targeted, but that's not a good plan anymore. No. A good mini break is sort of a way to use the stone wonder. Thank you for coming. And some potion. Okay. Oh, pretty nice. The dragon knows how to burst. I was not, honestly, I was not taking it too seriously, so I was not healing at all. There we go. My bad. Not a good move. Oh. No, but never mind. I got the limit break, so I can do my stuff. I better do it fast before the crystal falls. Okay, do your stuff. So many CCs. Oh, damn it. Oh, very nice. That was intensive. Okay. So we note victory for our Breaker goes up to 12. I don't put it down here and no. Currently one. And you will soon play that. And the team in the past fight was big. I got two stupid pets, They still manage to not die. I mean, usually when I die, it's like, oh my god, it's lost. These dudes can't do it without me. Sounds pretty arrogant, I know, but that's how it's most of the time. Hello. We don't have time here. I don't like this. I'm usually more comfortable when there's at least one enemy tank in the enemy team, because else I cannot use Nebula, and Nebula is very good for Gunbreaker. In my case, it is more important to have some defense and counter than just more defense. I did with this job. Machine is being break. It's not going to go. It's not going to go. This guy is not even moving anymore. Okay. He's not even trying. Try without any break. A bit desperate, but I was now on the allies. Good things. I don't need any one. No. Oh. I was again. This is very intense. I need to do the thing again. Do the thing, come on! Oh no. Come on guys, you can do it! Not very possible. Enemy dragon, he's got the jam. Team is pretty good and allies are not that good, so these are going to be probably in all of it. Yeah. Well, I tried. Full Gun Breaker has a good read for this. So, yeah. Okay, it's Gun Breaker time. I mean, Warrior time. Warrior. I'm not so positive about the warrior, okay? It's in the list. But I don't think I'm that good with warrior. Currently, the warrior has more victories than Gunbreaker, but it has less honor defeat, so I don't think it has the same carry power than the other job. A book, actually. Okay, so as I say, the problem with warrior is I'm not so confident with this job as I am with, for example, Gunbreaker. It is true, it has more victories, but I think those were pretty much better than worse enemies, basically. The only thing I do with warrior is when I perch, I bunga bunga, do all my skills, and then I pretty much that. And of course, I don't think it's any bridge so good like I'm breaking. Bunga, here it goes. Okay, 2 damage. damage has like no clue. Not that good. I'm really bad with attack there, and I don't know why. Anyways. Knowing how to use potions, this mod is more important than that, but it's knowing how to use your mod. Especially if you know that the enemies are going to push you. He did it to me. Okay. So this is a warrior. You know, I close to you. Instead of waiting for the team, they are going on their own, and it's not very clever. Almost, let me see. But it worked. Okay. That's one for the warrior. Let's check here and... Corn gone. Oh, map change. Too bad I would like this your map. That's okay. The new map is pretty fun. As you can see so far, the two victories, one for the American, one for the warrior, they were not easy. It constantly feels like that was way harder than ranked, really. And I think it's not because the enemies are really always because normally it faces me with not really great allies, so.
Here.
see, that's what I meant with enemies not being too great. That summoner had a cover, so he could be using a potion at the moment, but he didn't. Usually in ranked, people take a potion whenever they have Paladin's cover. Seems the warrior is having a lot more of luck with the team, so another victory for warrior. Let's open the thing. And for the count, there we go. As you can see, Bane Warrior is just to press your buttons, go where the enemies are, and do a lot of damage in AoE, and that's all. What I usually do is what I do with other jobs, just to save the burst. You don't use them randomly, you save them and use them all at the same time. That tip that I give you for other jobs, you will see that I usually save everything to use it all in one single moment. Right now, for example. It didn't work, as it should have, but usually it's good enough for... So usually it's not... If you just randomly use your skills, you're not going to kill enemies. You have to surprise them. Thank you. we have to talk in the police and say goodbye to that. Warrior is having quite the good luck. So this is another victory for the Warrior. The Turgan Breaker is, I think, objectively, my Gun Breaker has more carry power than Warrior, but statistically it's not the same, right? Here we go, let's add another. I use it this way because so I can know if, for example, 3 is a new best win streak for Warrior. Its second best was only two victories in a row. But it's being fairly lucky now. is going on most. Use the new break out of this place. Whoa. Real. And then break. Okay. Yeah, it's a good combination. I also use badness. Do you have some troublesome problematic enemy? Real and demon break. What are you doing here? Did he really waste fucking dragon living break in Guan? Dead guy. That was a little bit of an over the tier. Please guys, deal with the crystal. I have a mission. It didn't work. But I was trying to let it. Now we switch. Get ready. Limit break of the white mesh. Really nice. So yeah, clearly the warriors have a lot of luck. Enemies are not good, and it's good. It's going fine. And this is by far its best win streak. Streak? I don't know how to say it. At this rate, this is going to be a warrior-only festival. Okay, these are more enemies than we can do with this MP. Oh, bye bye. Break. It didn't work, thankfully. I have seen so many teams wipe by just one in break. Not that I hate a poor bard, but he has the limit break, and, you know, it's not good if he boosts his allies. Thank you. Okay, same time of you. Wasting the limit break, but I should have no waste. Well deserved, and it's time for check. White. Okay, so this is 4 when it's great. It's time for the white mage. White mage, by the way, has 8 wings in a row. It was crazy. I don't know what happened. Maybe a lot of luck, but she was very crazy. So with warrior, and the gameplay was to go there and do whatever. With white mage, it's a pity. You heal a lot. So you heal a lot. It's mostly you go do some DPS, and the DPS is just one moment of burst. You will see it in action. So white mage can do 2 things. Thing 1, leader burst, and thing 2, leader burst plus limit break. And that's all it can do. But surprisingly, it's very effective in carrying some battles. I mean, at least it's more effective than I ever thought it could be. Because white mage was not one of my most used jobs in Crystalline Conflict. So, white mage, burst, heal, shield, and annoy the enemies. And this is just clear, unlike in PvE, that you mostly spam glare, shield glare is the last thing you want to do. It's the least priority. Why? Well, better to heal an ally with 12. For 8 HP, than just deal 5 damage to an enemy. Like it or not, huge. Could be a priority. And sometimes you feel like not worthy to kill these guys because they are not doing anything, but yeah, heal them. Okay, that you died too fast. Oh, whoa! What was that? Okay, these guys now auto defeats. Our first ally died too fast. First, so that I do have not going to be an easy fight. Panic. Oh, you can do it. Right now, still. Another moment. Ah, whatever. Oh, allies, where are you? Poor White Mage didn't have been much chance to do anything this sprint. So that means it's time for the Sage. Let's go. White Mage has another one and Sage time. Okay, rule number one of being Sage in PvP. Carly, you use it on yourself. Now we go. At least in my case, it's way more useful to have it myself. So what Cordelia does is when I put some poison on the enemies, it hit me an extra toxic on you and clearly more damage.
worth it.
Silent in this one, but okay. So one for the sage. This one had little more than the poor white mage.
Thank you.
So similar to the warrior, sage doesn't have a very long win streak. It usually wins one and dies one, so it's probably that one. Well, at least the red mage is waiting for the team and it's not going solo. How did you die so fast already? Oh, damn. Okay. I suppose it was Gunbreaker, Springbreaker. Kill unprepared mind in right here. If they let me. No. Yeah, as I said, one victory, one defeat is always Sage cures. At least it tries. So, tanks and healers are gone, it's for the DPS ninja first. Well, ninja is you have seen me using the ninja a lot in frontlines, one of my funny jobs to play. But in Crystalline Conflict I don't think I'm really good with ninja. I just I don't think I have enough carry power like any other jobs. But at least it's a really fun one to play. Again, another fierce fight in which MTS have a lot of damage and allies just black that guy.
Thank you.
Even with that, I'm on fire. Okay, so poor ninja didn't have enough. It's time for So, Dragoon, in case you didn't see it, it's like the king of the honor defeats. Usually when it's defeated, it has the most damage. It's normal if you now know how to defeat Dragoon, that's a lot of damage, regardless. Unless the enemy team are too good, they are focusing you too much, and I think. And of course, this is not a really good map for Dragoon. I prefer the new map or the Vulcano. This is not that awesome for Dragoon. But let's see how it goes. Gunbreaker didn't have a really good team. This is the 1% of fights that are too easy and feels a bit strange. So that's one Dragoon that's going. Let's see. There. Where is it? My instant queue. Where is it? Are you sure you want to invent the black mage? Okay. This guy is to use a potion. Then I will do Dragon's Sting. Dragon's Sting 6. Well, Dragon thinks he should have killed the dragon, but okay. Another one could be. Actually having a bit less bad luck than lately. Oh, this dancer, he knows. So, to be honest, there is no other BTS to keep them. Samurai is not a good option for dancer. I know it because this dancer myself, so. Do you use your vein break? Yes. Nicely waved flame right here. You know, Paladin didn't raise his 50% defense to your allies. That limit break has been used there and not. Okay. Very wasted. Time to do problems. To be honest, together with Gunbreaker, Reaper, Machinist, I think Dragon is one of the most broken Crystalline Conflict jobs if you know how to use it. Black Mage is actually pretty good as well, but I don't know, Dragon has its charm. Just go there, jump, kill things, and it's pretty fun. So let's add another one for the dragon. Regardless, if you look at this, the dragon has 14 victories and 10 defeats, so it's not a good victory defeat ratio anyways. It has got a lot of bad luck that these 7 own refits. So. Even here. Don't attack that water, attack me. Is just how furtive, how sudden you are. You appear out of nowhere and you kill. They don't even see it coming. This is probably going to be one of those honor defeats. the dragon. Because the team is not, reacting. Like, with the ninja, it's having a lot of problems with that. This is dragons. Stuff all the whole time. Okay, the poor thing lost, so it has to change. The next one is the monk. I'm not very confident with the monk. Crystalline, I have not used it in frontline ever. I only use it in Crystalline Conflict. It's fun, but I don't think it's as good as the others, and even the stats against him. So, I and of course, no, the job of an eternal honor to feel. Would you be curious about the victory rate of Dragon in more recent and battles like Rat? Okay, so monk's thing is to just be that annoying little fluff that is hitting the enemies all the time and having some extra defense, some stun, CCs, some push. And similar to Reaper, you go and try to defeat the most annoying and dangerous enemies of the team. The difference is you have less overall damage, but your limit break is almost an insta kill if you use it properly. parkour with that ninja. World of stands. And I'm the one that's going to take them all. I didn't know that I got this box. Yeah, and Monk did it to everyone. So next one is Reaper. Reaper is actually the melee with more victories. It was honestly a surprise because it was not a job I ever used in frontline and rarely use it in crystalline, so it was a surprise. That it could have so many victories and so much carry power. It doesn't have a lot of damage, but Reaper's thing is to you just how to say it. You survive a lot. You can run away a lot and teleport, have a shield, and you have a pretty nice burst in single target. Like, I have never done too many duels, but I think in one-on-one, Reaper is probably the best job ever. Well, in finding out with this, this is actually a very good map for travel, if not the best.
Okay.
Most of the allies are already dead. Thank God. Good anyways. It's probably going to be a defeat. Team stay on crystal to heal. Thank you. Okay, that was a very hard-earned victory. Pretty nice. So yeah, that's what Reaper does. It's not a lot of damage like Dragon because you don't have many AoE or plentiful harvest, but you have a lot of survivability. You can escape easily with teleport, you have a shield, and you can burst enemies really fast. So let's keep it that. Let's play. Get the three of them here. Not bad. Demon said any monk how to play. Of course they have sticky that one. I don't know actually where is the rest of mine. No, like seriously, where are they? It's going to be that type of fight. Really, where are they? I don't see allies. no, bad luck. It happens. Really hard, right? I'm trying, but oh, damn it. just look at that. Our dragon has the linear blade and he's not using it. Okay. Simply not. Not possible. Not with this deal. Full Reaper only had one this time. Well, it goes to 19, like the White Mesh, and now it's time for range. Dancer. Dancer is another one with very curious luck regarding the enemy teams, the allies, the ball. So let's go, let's see how it goes. I think it's actually a very good map for that. So thank you. understand, I don't understand. My friends. Really good, man. Well done there. Like the samurai fox. Oh, wait, I know. There is few warrior move that are on your own HP. This is another of those. Thank you, Paladin. No, Paladin, don't die! Don't die yet. Okay. Time to die, people. Always take the damage shot, I think. Oof. This was a nice story. Dancer. Machinist or Zoom. Both are really good options. I don't know any of these guys, Zoom, just in case. They are already a bit tanky, so this buff take less damage, less damage. More stuff. Actually, dying sometimes with the dust is good because it refreshes my defeat. I just hate listening at that sound of the whole party being just like that. What you were trying there, but I got the limit break, so I went back to bad time. They come all together. There was something on this guy. Now it's all on my team, but no. Warrior wasn't even in the list. On a defeat at least. Just I hate when you look at the damage deal that you see on your allies down here. Except one. I should have given it to the machinist. Well, Dancer got it that way. It's usually like the stage. You win one, you lose one. It's pretty funny about that. You are supposed to be a job only for coding, not to deal with most damage. Next is Machinist. Unless we have a really cool stem. Like, as you can see, Magnus is the one that's having currently most of the victories. I don't know, the job is in all of it. You have a limit break, this that kill almost anyone. If you use currently, you have some AoE damage with dot, you have the turret. The turret is really good for Crystalline Conflict. And it's a pretty fun job to use overall. The bad thing about mechanics in this map is that ranged don't have a good line of sight. As you can see, there's a lot of place to hide from my attacks. And that's not good, at least for mechanics. Even less for bars, but I like this map, so it's okay. Regardless of the job I use. Regardless, this is one of those fights in which you can see the enemy team being way too overpowered in comparison to your own team. Dragon did his thing. They didn't even warp, so. Oh, okay. Where am I killing Stein after you are going to stay 22 victories? So, what do we kill? Thank you. that is not possible. So yeah, me, say, hey, look, Makin has 22 victories, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, it's for nothing. That dragon is focused me all the time. Yeah, no. Impossible. I just delay the inevitable. Look at these kids. Okay, no, not good luck for the machine, so it's a bound. Another honor. It's actually been in the same level than Gunbreaker and Fisher in that weather. And probably Red Massive. Let's see if it is going to be the same. So I think, depending on how bad or good the string goes, we can cover a whole round. Meaning all of them take 11 defeats, it's only 4 jobs remaining. Okay, so what is Bard's thing? Bard's thing is to annoy people. You don't. Actually, you have a burst, you can do pretty decent damage also then with these things. But your main task is to annoy them. You have silence, you have bind, and you have a lot of tools to make sure they suffer. Not really with damage, but with not how we intend to play. You also buff your allies' damage, but as you can see, that is not very useful. Please. I got a silence from the start. That's what it is. It's over time. I love that. But I don't love his my allies dying, so. How to fix this? I think that dragon was in the previous match. It's pretty dangerous. So let's focus that much. And break. here goes bad lead raid. Moving your allies at Arnhem. So it's not a really good maneuver in this game. Mark is going to have bad this one. No. I mean, you are not supposed to be in the crystal spot either. Look at this. Okay, bad luck. So as I say, the casual can be way more criminal than ranked. For example, in ranked, Bard will not have more defeats than victory. Because actually, buffing your allies, you are like, competent. Enemies are competent as well, but you are hindering their process with silence, bind, all that. And they're going. They're not thinking well about it. Okay. So, weak mage. Black Mage is from the casters, is a pretty strong one and very solid in damage. You have a lot of TP as well, you can sweep the enemies, you can freeze them. It's a lot of fun. So we are heading close to finishing one of the rounds, 11th. It's just that the caster remaining. It's Black Mage, then Summoner, and then Red Mage. Each one of them is there, it's some points. As I said, for example, in this one case, if having enough luck with the boost and explosions of the map, coinciding with my limit rate, I could risk the whole enemy team and take or take explosion. It's a lot of fun. So let's see how this goes. Well, they did good because focusing the black mage is always a good idea. Should have go for a restart, but they were too focused in killing people. Thank you. of War. That was actually my hope. You don't have to die because I appreciate the empathy, but not needed really. Please survive. It's really annoying. And bind as well. One for the black pain. As you can see, black mage is pure destruction. Really fun job as well. And I think it's going to take an explosive machinist if it has some good luck.
Thank you.
focusing. So I see all the enemies with a lot of MP except the one currently attacking. One of those fights, right? Unlike the previous one, this one is not going to work. It's some other time. I still pretty good to have to, considering my lag lately, and 2 weeks is not bad. It went into the 20 area.
Thank you.
Well, Summoner is very similar to the Warrior. You dive into the enemies, deal a lot of damage. That's about it. You just have to be extra wary and careful when you got the limit break, because your limit break does a lot of damage. But decent enemies will always try to take you down when you use it. What is, well, it's common sense. So you have to use the heal before limit break. For the tour and Gunbreaker, because, well, Machinist, because he tried to protect me at the limit break at the it wasn't what. Let's give it a go. It's really one there. Uh oh. Holy shield.
Yeah. you're asking now.
Really? Yeah, one of those fights. So the last one of the bullet is the red mage. Red mage is very similar to monk and reaper. And your task is to pretty much go one on one and kill them. Pretty simple. The thing is, your game break is not so one on one focus like monk. It's more like AoE. You have to combine it well with bear flare or with silence. In any case, no luck for the poor summoner. Just another honor.
Thank you.
all those damage stacks just for nothing. As you can see, many people say that PvP in this game is dead. Probably is right. But if you go to casual and match of Crystalline Conflict, you will always have instant pro. Absolutely looks like one of those fights. Are not going for the crystal. They are actually ignoring the crystal. Okay, that's it. So, not a gonna benefit this time. Sorry, Red Mage, you're not increasing that thing. And well, that was it. That completes the whole end roulette. Let's edit. As you can see, it's pretty mean, pretty difficult to do as well if you don't have the map by your side. It's like you try and you can't carry as much. Well, obviously, there's some cover. I mean, only Monk and Bard have actually more defeats than victories. The rest of the jobs have way more on that. But it's still not as much as I would love. That's definitely, I think so. Well, I hope that you have enjoyed this little festival of PvP and Crystalline Conflict. Try to play it yourself and see how it goes. It's unlike the Feast, I played in the first season of the Feast, all Heavensward PvP. Heavensward PvP was really fun with problems. It has a lot of things in the Feast as well. But for example, Stormblood, it's a Shadowbringers, it's a at least in the Feast. Crystalline Conflict, I think it's more dynamic, more active. There's more stuff going on. I don't know how to explain, but you have to try it yourself. It's very, very fun. And the only thing is, well, it's not a 4 versus 4, it's 5 versus 5. So obviously it's hard to try and parry because you depend on other four allies, four five enemies, yeah, like that. So yeah, that was it for tonight. I might do tomorrow another one and before the 12th round. Thank you a lot for watching and bearing with my English. I said it on purpose, I'm English, you know, because, well, that was it for this time. See you in the next.